Hello and welcome, guys. This is God of Slumber back with some more awesome World of Tanks action. Now, I've been fighting in the Baltic League these last 2 days, one on one versus one, from the 56 participants from the Baltic states. I managed to fight someone and a few people, and you're gonna see how I did and what I had to do and how far I got and what I had to do to get there. You're gonna see the battle. The battles are quick, although there are gonna be many. I hope you enjoy, and so this is what it took. Of course, I used my trusty IS-3, the in my opinion the best tier 8 heavy tank. I've had over 1,500 battles with this, and loved every single one of them. This is an awesome tank, and you're gonna see how it and me did. So, let's get to the first battle. Hello and welcome, guys. This is the first battle of the Baltic League with my trusty IS-3. I hope you enjoy the battle. This battle is against the Estonian player, Miki Von here. I hope I pronounced it somewhat correctly. And, let's get on with it. Well, I decided I'm gonna go ahead with the 8th line, the so-called banana, and just rush home forward since I haven't played in Baltic League 1 versus 1 since forever. I can't even remember the last time I played it. I think I have played it once. The first shot bounced and he missed. At that point I knew the battle was basically mine because I managed to do the first shot. Even if he lands all his shots, I still am going to make it. So the first was a fine hit and he hit me. Damage was more or less equal. I did a 30 more than he did, actually. The section was also connected, and at this point I am the victor already, since he has absolutely no chance of dealing because I'm already reloaded. Yeah, and this is basically where it ends. If we exchange a couple more shots now, this is where the RNG could have fucked me, literally. And it actually did, so 15 HP left, but there's no chance he can do 499 damage, and he even missed that one shot. And that's the end of that, so I'll see you on the next one. So, the second battle, this time I decided I'm gonna go through the hill, change a little bit of tactic, see what's what, since I still have very little idea what I am doing. He's a good sport, so we wished each other good luck. And when the battle went on, be a little bit driving, going around, seeing what, enjoying the scenery. Can you find the enemy? Come on, where are you, man? Where are you, dude? And there he is, right behind me. I actually landed that first shot and he missed that one again. And I missed that one. At this point I thought, ooh, I'm screwed. But he chickened out for some reason. I don't know. I have no idea why he chickened out on me. Next film. The odds were in his favor. He landed every shot perfectly. And the next one. This was how close I got. Basically, half a second. If I would have put the extra rations in, I would have won this battle. But RNG and my mistakes combined let him win this. And on to the next one. And this is the last out of the three battles. So, as previously, we're good sports, so we should each other good luck. Now, this is the 16 part finals. I don't know how you call them. 16 or whatever. So, the first shot I landed, he bounced. Actually, damaged my track a little bit, but The battle is already decided basically at this point, unless I miss a shot. So our shots are exchanged. I'm already 300 hit points ahead of him. Same shot, below the average. And now he was charging me. And that's end of, that's the end of that. The first match, 2-1 points, and I win with my good and trusty and loved IS-3. I hope you like that, and I'll see you on the... Now, the mines. I like this map. I really, really do. Basically, it's pretty small map, easy to play. Played a lot of time wars in this map. Against me is Mr. Dickinson. Well, make that with what you want. Now, against the T-32, I was a little scared because if the previous player was by stats more or less as good as I, as good as me, you have some like your work, and I see you anywhere. There is some more lighting. If I was a little afraid of the previous battle. Of this battle than the first battle, was just, I don't have no idea what he did, what happened there, or what was the deal with this, but this was an easy win. Even though this player was by stats more skilled, much more skilled than I was. And that was the first victory for me, so 1-0, and let's get on to the next one. So the second battle, changing sides, going on to the advance. This time I decided I'm going to go around, trying not to knock over in the case he has some fucking mods. Never know. You should trust people, but in this case there's a lot of gold at stake, and I didn't want to risk it. So. And. Interestingly enough, I was expecting him to be somewhere around these parts. I never guessed that he would end up being on the hill. Strangely enough, but there he was. Now, I'm gonna admit, at the beginning of the fight, I fucked up incredibly. The RNG raped my face without even asking permission, and my skill was basically, it looked, this battle looks like this is the first day I got my IS-3, and I've never played with this before. I have no idea why, but for some reason RNG also didn't want me to win. So if you want to have a good laugh, then here's your chance. Second bounce. This is gonna go on for a while now. Guess where I'm gonna land? 4 shots. Now, I guess I decided that I could destroy the hill. That's 1 shot in the ground. That's the 2nd shot in the ground. Here comes the 3rd shot in the ground. No, third time's the charm, but nope, still in the ground. How about the 4th time? 4th time for the heart. How about it? So, can I land the 4th shot? Yes, I can, but unfortunately, using the tracks, now I'm the track without the repair. And finally, I did some damage. I actually shot him. That, of course, wasn't enough, and I lost this one quite horribly. Very ashamed of this battle, but 1-1. It all comes down to the last but not least 3rd battle. Let's go. So the last 3rd battle, the winner moves on to quarterfinals with all healing for a heat, where the winner gets already at least 500 gold and the loser goes home with nothing. very intense. My hands were actually shaking. I don't know why. I was very stressed out because I knew this player by stats was better than me. Even though the stats don't always matter. Now I decided I'm gonna go full frontal, so like no holding back. Somewhat camp fired. I was expecting him to come out. Thought maybe I'm gonna switch to HE rounds, try to do some damage with those, but didn't want to waste any bullets. I hesitated. And saw him getting back. What is this? Got back. Okay, so I'm gonna drive up. And but this time I got my rations with me, without the fire extinguisher, and I said, fuck it, I'm gonna full frontal assault him. And see what I can do. And detract. He's assaulting, you know, he's coming after me. Fix my gun. He's doing damage for exchanging right now. This is what it looked like. Now, as soon as I got by his side, I knew I was victim. We just realized we won, and that's it for you, buddy. And with that, I actually managed to get into the quarterfinals, which landed me at least 500 gold. And let's go. Let's check out what the quarterfinals actually look like. This was, I believe, the end of day one. So the one versus one goes on for 2 days, and well, next up, quarterfinals, and it's time for the quarterfinals. The map is a Siegfried's line. Now I dread this map. I really don't like it. I play clan wars in it, ranked battles, and I don't know, maybe not ranked battles, but company battles maybe. And I dislike this map a lot. Now, the player against who I'm playing against is a very strong player, Duncan Lords from the clan Lavi. By stats, I believe I'm allowed to say he's twice as good as me. Now, this guy is really a pro, and basically have nothing to do here. Now, what you're gonna see here is something I thought I saw oddly suspicious. Now, if you noticed, I didn't knock over anything. No cars, no fences, no trees, nothing. Now, what strange me out the most was... this. He was... He knew I was there. How is that possible? I mean, I didn't knock over anything, but he was already aiming at my sides. That is the part that I found really strange. Then I landed my first hit, and at this point I thought the battle was over, but he bounced a shot. This player with his high ranking bounced two shots in a row against me, and I thought RNG was holding my hand all the way. Now the damage, 430 damage, that's way above average. Now I clearly saw that RNG was helping me out on this, and that was it. That he landed the first shot but bounced two in a row, and I believe he shot one at my gun tip. So, very strange and very fast battle. Less on my skill, more on that the RNG helped me, and his lack of skill, which I find very strange. But after the battle, I checked his stats, and he didn't have that many battles on that 110. And the 110 has 100mm gun, so it does less damage than the IS-3. Why would you use it is beyond me, but I guess he had a good reason. So it's 1-0, and I gotta say I was feeling pretty damn good. Now the second battle against Duncan Lords. Now I gotta say, at this point I was really, really excited. I won a battle against such a good player, and I didn't know what was going to happen. So I thought, well, let's play and see. I'm just gonna do try to do my best, and I'm gonna go the same as previously, full frontal assault, fuck everything in my path, and just let's go and throw this down. I decided to go to the left, maybe try to cap the base, get him in my sights first. Now, the last place I expected him to see him was behind me, and I thought, oh, this is it, yep, I'm dead. Nope, actually no, he hesitated. I don't know what happened, maybe I got out of his range or behind a corner or something, but he hesitated. And I thought, okay, well, if I turn around, he's going to be in front of me and shoot me on sight. But at the moment I got around the corner, he wasn't there. And this really confused me. I thought, okay, he's going to be behind this corner. And he's not. He's on the other side of this block. I thought, what the hell? Is this dude for real? I mean, come on. He's bound to be a fair play. Did I scare him? What is going on? So I didn't want to waste my shot. I had an opportunity. I had an opening. I could have taken the shot, but I decided I'm wrong. So I did. Turned out to be a rushed shot. Shouldn't have done that. Could reload. Hoped he's going to get out of the corner, but as we all know, this is not the random battles filled with bots and so on. So. A high stakes, and it connected. The shot connected. He destroyed my tracks. I immediately repaired, and I was already ahead for 300 points. So at this point, I was feeling very confident about myself. But the second shot bounced. Gold shot bounced again. 110 tens armor, and he landed that shot. Now I was behind 200 hit points and 399, a good average damage. Is he going to make it? No, he bounced. See, this is where the 100mm gun lacks its potential. He bounced that shot, and I thought, well, that's it, and I bounced mine. But he did, he shot me in the gun. He damaged my gun. So this battle is now going on with a damaged gun in my eyes. Anything can happen to him, but the shot connected, went a little below damage, average damage now at this point. He has 390 hit points, I have 501. Now, I get a chance to do at least two shots, because he can't take me with a one shot. I'm not a one shot kill for him. But, should I miss one, and the other shot, the RNG on that shot, didn't like me that much, and decided, nope, I'm going to do 389 damage, and leave him with one shot, I would have killed myself. Literally, I would have jumped out of the window right now, because this has happened so many times, and I begged all of the gods of the world of RNG that I could. The RNG is so to save me, and well, let's see what happened. And it connected. 390 damage went through, and he's dead, and I am alive. This player with such great stats made two consecutive mistakes in the first round, in the first battle, where he bounced those shots, even though he connected the first shot. And on this battle, with a damaged gun, I managed to kill him. And so 2-0. This was an easier battle. Easier to battle against in the map I don't like, against a player who's much more skilled than me in the map that I don't like. I won 2-0, which was very surprising. So now I was going to onto the half finals battle for a chance to battle for the first or second or third or fourth battle, and let's see how I did there. Now, this battle against Mr. Zaynukas from, I believe, the strongest Lithuanian clan, the first LT clan. Now, this player was even more skilled than the previous one, which was my countryman. This was a Lithuanian player, and I thought, well, I am fucked. This couldn't get any worse, but I thought, I'm already in the half finals. I already got 1,000 gold, so screw it. Let's go full forward. Only the W key on my keyboard, And let's see what I can do. He was with the T-32, which I found pretty funny. I don't know why would you fight against me with a T-32, but okay. His choice, I guess. This is his side, and the first shot connected with 447 damage. Now, he only did to me 252? Yeah, 252 if my math is correct. Which, I basically did almost twice as much as he did to me, and, well, this was already very strange. Now, the second shot, of course, below average, 350. Now, we're already 300 points in front of him. Well, not anymore, but still, come on, I did track him, and 375, now this is where the RNG could have fucked me again, and what happened was, he rushed for me, now I knew I couldn't connect the shot, but I got to his side, and 3 HP, thank you RNG, thank you very much, or should I say, fuck you very much. 3 hit points. This is the typical battle. This is typically what happens to me when I get into a random battle with my S3 and RNG just fucking rapes me without asking permission. I would put this on Pornhub, but unfortunately they don't allow rape. So here you have it on YouTube. I hope if they don't ban this, because this is fucking brutal. This hurts so much. But still, nevertheless, 285 on me. Full reload to do, so 11 seconds, and small gun on the Zenyukas, sorry. Well, here we go, on the Ruinberg. Remember, this is the half finals, a chance to battle for first or the third place. Winner goes to the big finals for the first, second place, and loser goes to the low finals for the third and fourth place. And well, let's see what happens next. He bounced the shot, and that's it for him. Those 3 goddamn hit points are over. And yeah, RNG. So 1-0 against the player who's more skilled than the previous. Now, let's see what happens in the next battle. Now, the battle is starting, and I gotta say, my heart was racing at this point. I have beaten a player who was incredibly skilled, whose WN8 was above the charts. He was a unicorn. The almost mind-blowingly good player. And I thought, well, I nailed one. I goddamn nailed one. And I thought, I'm gonna change my tactics up a little bit, because I know he's higher and I would have to shoot from the bottom up, and he has a better gun depression. So I chose to go around, trying not to knock anything over, so in the case that he has some forbidden mods, he couldn't see me. And, well, this is gonna be a long drive, so let's speed it up a little bit. Driving, checking out the destroyed town. Still checking it out. I thought, okay, well, this is far enough. Okay, where is he now? Let's go to the left and see if we can see it. Now, I was afraid he's going to be somewhere near the line 9 or 0, and that made me very nervous. Luckily enough, found him, and he was on the 0 line. Now, I know this place is rocky and has hills, and I was a little afraid about what was going to happen, so the first shot, wall, and he bounced. Well, I was so lucky, so happy that he bounced that first shot. The second one connected, he detracted without damage. Third bounce, this is why you shouldn't push the small gun, and I bounced. His fourth bounce, he has just bounced 4 shots, one without the damage. 380, I hit a building, finally, he does damage to me. And he hit my fuel tanks, which I was afraid of, but around the corner, side hit for 30 damage, and I was feeling very lucky. 900 hit points, almost 1000 hit points from me, he detracted me, but I have no repair kit, and I was really afraid at this point. Thought, holy crap, if he has HE rounds, he can start pounding me in the ground. And I couldn't do shit. Now, even though I have 4 skills on this tank. There's no chance I could have repaired so fast. But luckily enough, he bounced again and again. And after this round, I had 1920 damage blocked by my armor. Now, again, he rushed me and I made a shot. 2-0, I've beaten this player. Boom, here comes the finals. Battle for the first place. Let's get it on. Hello, guys, and now the finals. The battle for the first place in the Baltic League. Almost 56 players, me and Mr. Thundrix5 with the C32. We're the ones with the most skill, most luck, and whose RNG stood by their side, and who got the chance to fight for the first place. Now, I was already stoked. I knew I already got the 3,000 gold, and I didn't. If the previous battle was stressing me out, my hands were shaking, heart pounding, and so on and so on. In this battle, I was pretty easy going. Like, I thought, I'm gonna just go full frontal and see what I can do. Now, this battle, I gotta warn you, this battle is going to be the purest and most beautiful show of how to fuck up a Baltic League's battle in the world. Like, this is the best fuck up possible. Keep in mind, I have over 1500 battles on this tank, crew with 4 skills, and yeah. You are allowed to laugh your asses off at me about what happens at the very, very crucial and important moment of this battle. Now, I see him. He sees me. He lands the first shot. I landed also for 23 damage. I make a circle around him. He lands the second shot. And I land the second shot. 246. Now, watch this. Just watch it. I have no fucking idea what the hell just happened. Maybe it was some sort of incline or on the ground. Whatever the hell that shit was. How the hell did I just, instead of making a shot here, or anywhere around here, I made a shot right over there where the tip of that triangle is. How was that even remotely possible with all the skills and all those battles on this tank? I have no idea. This is the biggest bullshit, the biggest fuck up I've ever made, and at the best possible battle. I would give up 1,000 random battle victories for that one goddamn shot. That clinically insane sample shot from 35 meters. 30 fucking 5 meters. I missed the shot on a stationary T-32 tank with a gold ammo from 35 meters. I mean, I've fucked up in my life a lot of times, but this is the one I regret, like, a lot. Of course, then the battle is already decided at this point. Sorry for the little cut. And there's nothing that I can do right now at this point. And he's basically just ending me. This is it. This is where it ends. 380. But would have been closer to him. Maybe I would have landed a bounce shot, tried to maybe dance a little bit, but yeah. That was me fucking up perfectly. This was the perfect example how not to play in the Baltic League battle. Even though he landed the first shot, I would have won if I hadn't fucked up from 35 meters. So I have no idea what happened to me at that split second, but it happened. It was a noob error, a noobish mistake. With those kind of mistakes, I didn't get to the finals. I have no idea what happened at this point, but 0-1 in his favor. So let's see what happens into the next battle. Now, the second battle in the Baltic Finals 1-1, the battle for the first place. Now, if he wins, he gets 4,000 gold. Yeah, 4,000 gold. And the title of the winner of this cup. And if I win, I get a chance to battle him again in the third one. Now, yeah, still sore from that previous fuck up. Ashamed to bone. I thought, okay, you know, I'm gonna change a little bit of tactic, but still go full frontal assault. And there he was. Over the tracks, he landed the first shot again of 464. Now the RNG was really loving me in this battle. I have no idea why I just engaged the automatic unloading, but I disengaged immediately, maybe a stupid reflex. Now the damage dealing is almost the same right now. Same tactic, spinning around, knowing that he can't turn so fast, and at this point the battle is over. He landed that one shot. There's no chance I'm gonna miss this time, hopefully, and he loses. This was the critical turning point in the tournament, which basically decided the outcome. Hendrix is an intermediate, he's a smart player, he knows how to deal with situations, and if I would have landed that shot that I missed in the previous battle, the tournament would have ended here, and I would have been declared the winner. Unfortunately, it's not how it turned up, and I had to fight a third battle with Hendrix in Prokhorovka, a map which largely favors T-32 tank. So the last battle in World of Tanks Baltic League Cup 1-1. Let's get it on. Now the last battle for the Baltic League Cup 1-1 finals. Whoever's the winner in this battle is the winner in the whole cup and goes to garage with 4,000 gold. Still sore about that shot. I'm still ashamed by it. Now I know this battle is. I had a feeling that it not might go too well for me. Fortunately, I have no idea how bad this is going to turn out for me. If in the first battle I blame my somewhat lack of skill or some mysterious thing that happened to me in the tournament, then in this, there's nobody to blame. Hendrix turned out to be the best player in this battle, and all congratulations to him. He deserved the victory. And now you're going to see how he ended up with that victory in the moment. Sorry for the cut ending, my PC is acting up a little. Basically, as soon as I knew he was so far in the distance and he landed that first shot on me, I knew I had no chance of getting anywhere near to him. My mistake was I should have drawn him to the cap and dropped the cap in the base, but unfortunately I didn't. I was too obsessed with getting those 3,000 gold that I didn't really care much for a victory. And I still couldn't see him. He landed that shot and I couldn't see him. He got another shot and I couldn't see him. D-tracked me and I still don't see him. And I still don't see him. That's 4 or 5 shots. Again, still can't see him. I had to drive up to him to, I don't know, how close to actually do a battle. Sorry for the lags, my PC is acting up a little bit. But yeah, that one shot was all I could manage to do. Now this is the difference. This is the difference that a battle makes when you're fighting an IS-3 against a T-32 up close, and what it looks like when you fight for the distance. No chance, absolutely no chance. The only chance I got was I should have driven to the cap circle and started to cap. That would have been my only chance to get him up close, to fight against him, and maybe I would have won. That was my mistake. He won. He realized that in order to kill me, to take the first place, he had to keep a distance between me and him. That's exactly what he did, so all congratulations on Andrix 5. Thank you for the awesome game. And still, second place amongst 56 players, out of whom mostly were uber good players. So all respect to Andrix, and this was my experience in the Baltic League 1v1 battles. I don't know what more to add. I hope you enjoyed this. Sorry for the lags in the end, I don't know why. But I'll see you sometime in the future. Take care.